I have been attending Warrnambool City Council open meetings for 8 years now. In that time, I have seen some great ideas put to council, only to be voted against for 3. Then I have seen some of these great ideas brought back to council 12 to 18 months later by a different councillor and voted in unanimously. I have seen this happen time and time again over my years in the gallery. Why were these ideas not voted in unanimously when first brought to council and acted upon 12 to 18 months earlier? Warrnambool would have been better off for this. A good idea is a good idea, no matter who brings it to council. It has taken 14 years just to get a safe crossing for the elderly in Corroit Street. Seriously, 14 years for a crossing? I believe council can and should do better than 14 years. Vic Health has just made available $1.3 million for councils to apply for under their Alcohol Cultural Change Grant Program. As only 4 councils will be chosen from the applications for this funding, now is the time for Warrnambool City Council to stop alcohol paid for by the ratepayers of Warrnambool for councillors and senior staff after all council meetings. In fact, this would be a great health and wellbeing strategy for Warrnambool City Council to put in place. Council needs to show by example. I envisage a council made up of 7 independent decision makers that show respect to every councillor and who can democratically debate issues on merit. I want to be part of a council that can progress Warrnambool into the future with councillors that are interested in the betterment of this great city. In October this year, have your say by making your vote count. Vote 1, Christine Thompson, candidate for positive change.